A man's pet rattlesnake nearly kills him. How'd it happen?
New information about O.J. Simpson's arrest. Hear who's saying the former football player was set up.
And the family of a woman who died after police officers tasered her heads to court. They're suing police. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Rob Sweeney.
And I'm Jennifer Waugh. A Clay County woman's family says they want justice after their loved one was tasered during a confrontation with police.
Soon they will take the police department to court. It's our big story at 5:30. 56-year-old Emily Delafield died April 2006 after officers in Green Cove Springs went to her home. Police say Delafield was in her wheelchair armed with two knives and a hammer. They say she wouldn't give up her weapon, so they tasered her. New at 5:30, Channel 4's John Dunlap talked with the family's attorney about this case. John?
Rob, the family's attorney and the family have been waiting for several months to get all the paperwork, all the statements and reports from the state so they could possibly pursue a lawsuit against the Green Cove Springs Police Department. They now have all this paperwork, and they believe they have enough evidence to win a case against the police department.
And what's the problem?
My sister is all invading on my privacy.
Your what?
My sister's trying to person is on my property trying to harm me.
What you just heard was the 911 call made to the Green Cove Springs Police Department by 56-year-old Emily Delafield. Within the hour of that call, Delafield, a wheelchair-bound woman documented to have mental illness, was dead. Family attorney Rick Alexander says her death could have been prevented and that there are four things that jump out about this case.
One, she's in a wheelchair. Two, she's schizophrenic. Three, they're using a taser on a person that's in a wheelchair. And then four, they tasered her 10 times for a period of like 2 minutes.
The medical examiner's report showed that Delafield had a heart condition and the tasering triggered her heart failure and ultimately her death. Her family plans to sue the Green Cove Springs Police Department now that they have all the reports regarding Delafield's death.
We're going to try to compensate the estate and the family and try to get justice out of it.
Alexander believes all the evidence weighs heavily in favor of Delafield's family and justice will be served.
I think that this evidence is going to show, along with some of the evidence we've collected outside of here, that there's no reason Emily Delafield should have died that day.
Now, we tried to contact the Green Cove Springs Police Department about this particular case. They did not return our phone calls. As far as a possible lawsuit, Alexander says he does intend to file a notice to sue sometime before the end of the year. We're live from the South Bank. John Dunlap, Channel 4, the local station.
We are tracking the tropics.